Namaste, my name is Dio and welcome to my channel. Today let's talk a little about why people can't handle it when their dreams come true or when their wishes come true. You know, a lot of people when they get fame, they can't handle it. A lot of people when they get a lot of money can't handle it. When people get their true love, they've been always wanting that true love, and once they get that true love, they just can't handle it. You know, and they destroy everything that they've got. So basically your dream, what you've been dreaming for, when your dream comes true, you yourself turn it into one big nightmare. You know, why are we doing that? Why are so many people doing that? You know, what is going wrong? So let's figure out what is going wrong and let's figure out what you can do to avoid that situation. Okay, so now the number one thing that you're taught in a survival school, like an outdoor survival school, one of the things that you are taught is if you are dehydrated, if you are in a situation, like if you're stuck in a desert and there's no water around you, okay, you've dehydrated for a couple of days, the minute you find some water somewhere, okay, you're not supposed to gulp that water down. Okay, you're supposed to take small sips, wait for some time, have another small sip. The amount of water you keep gulping, okay, in large quantities, it can be extremely harmful to your body. Okay, so basically your body has been dehydrated of an energy. Water is an energy, food is an energy, and the more you give it at one go, your body just rejects it. It just can't take it anymore. So similarly, fame is an energy. Okay, if you're famous, you're feeling good, you're feeling nice, or you could be feeling bad. Okay, if you're not famous, you're feeling bad and you're looking for fame. So it is an energy. Similarly, money is also an energy. It makes you feel good, it makes you feel bad. Okay, love is an energy. It makes you feel good, it makes you feel bad. Okay, health is also energy. A lot of energy that we are wishing for and we're dreaming for is basically something that we have deprived ourselves of. Okay, just like water is not there in our body, we are dehydrated. Similarly, we are wishing for money because we don't have that money. So the minute somebody, a lot of people, when they win that lottery, okay, they blow up that money in like a year's time, and when they go back to the previous situation, they're in a worse situation than what they were before. Okay, because they just cannot handle that amount of energy. This is why a lot of people when they get fame, and all of us know those examples and amount of people that we know, musicians and actors and a lot of other celebrities who the minute they get their fame, they worked hard all their life for it, but the minute their dreams come true, they just can't handle it because you've deprived yourself of that fame energy. And now when you've got that energy, your body is rejected, your life has rejected it. You just can't handle it anymore. Similarly with people who've made their goal that, okay, I want such and such physique, I want all muscled up, or I want to lose weight, or I want to bulk up. The minute they reach their goal, okay, they work so hard for it, but now they just can't handle that energy anymore. And when they start eating or when they stop working out, the situation is worse from where they've come. Okay, because we're depriving ourselves of that energy. Similarly with somebody who's not got love all their life, who's always been, say, cheated or has never been loved before. Okay, once they get somebody who's giving them so much of love that they just can't handle it, they think something's wrong with this person. This person has to be a cheat. You know, how is he being so nice to me? There's something wrong with this person. And things, circumstances around them become such that they reject that person from their life. Okay, and all this is happening because we ourselves have deprived ourselves of that energy. Okay, so if we were in a desert and we had a bottle of water, would we deprive ourselves of that water? No, we would keep sipping on it. So right now, the best thing to do is to avoid this situation is if you're looking for fame. Okay, now already consider yourself famous. Don't put a limit to what fame should be. Do you want 10 million people or 10 people? Okay, so even in your life, if you have 10 people who are fond of you, who are genuinely fond of you, consider yourself famous. Be humble, be in that gratitude that, man, I've got 10 people who are madly in love with me. It could be your friends, your family, your relationship, your dog, your pets, your cats, anybody. Okay, but already feel famous. Feel good, be humble. So tomorrow when you get your fame, okay, you're already humble, you're already in that gratitude that, yeah, I've already felt that fame before. Okay, so you can handle it much better. Similarly with money. So if you have $10, feel rich, it's your $10. Okay, somebody else might not even have that $10. Okay, and why put a limitation to what rich is? $10 is your $10. If the second person has $10 million, is he giving you that $10 million? No. That money is for him. Your $10 is for you. So you be rich in that $10. Okay, so when tomorrow you do get your loads of money, you've won the lottery or you've cracked something, all of a sudden you've got that money, you're already feeling rich, you're already feeling humble, gratitude. That you know you're already rich, you can handle that money. Similarly with love. Why are people waiting for somebody else to love them? I want somebody to love me. You love yourself. Okay? Love yourself doesn't mean, okay, go stand in the mirror and spend hours and, you know, no, just love yourself. Spend time with yourself. And I'll tell you something you should do to see how much people will love you or like you is try spending time just by yourself, without your cell phone, without your gadgets, without social media, without your television, music, nothing. Just be by yourself. If you can sit for only 2 minutes, then that's the amount of time people will like you. Being around you is only for those 2 minutes. If you can't like your own company, okay, how do you expect somebody else to like it? So start loving yourself, start loving your own company. So tomorrow when you do get somebody who loves you like crazy, you can handle that energy. Everything's energy. You can handle that energy. So feel good the way you are, in your own weight, in your own body. So tomorrow when you do achieve your goal, you can handle it. You can sustain that throughout the time. If you've gone on a crash diet and you've lost that weight, and immediately when you're looking at yourself and you've achieved your goal, you start eating again because you just can't handle that energy of being thin anymore, of being muscular anymore. Okay, so don't deprive of yourself from the energy that you're looking for also. Okay, we all have that energy, that little bit of fame, we all have those two people, that little bit of love, we do love ourselves. So bask in that energy throughout the time. Okay, so when your dream does come true, you're handling it much better. Okay, so please share this knowledge with people. Everyone that you know is looking to make their dreams come true or is not being able to handle their dreams. Explain to them, this is why it's happening. There's always time to make, it's never too late to make a difference in your life, right? So please share this knowledge with people, help them understand how they can handle things better, okay, in the future or in the present, how they can handle it better. And if you like this video, please give it a like, subscribe to my channel. Until I see you again, have a good life. Namaste.